Hey, so I'm back. I guess a welcome back to me is in order because I have not been on here for ages. I think the last video I did was more like a keto grocery haul, and in that video I told you guys that there wouldn't be a lot of makeup or beauty related videos as much as before. Like, I was religiously like putting up videos, I think like 3 times a week before, that's beauty related, but that's died down. It's been a couple of months since, I don't even remember what was the last beauty video that I put up with. And in case you were curious, nothing bad happened. I just started living life outside of YouTube. I've taken up cycling. I've got my big ass bike sitting in the living room right now, parked, because I would not leave it outside. It's too expensive to be stolen. I have also, you know, been making friends, playing badminton. Yeah, and been really busy with work, so that's why I haven't been on here for a while. And to be honest, I have also had I've like been in the funk with makeup for a while. There wasn't really anything that was coming out that I thought I wanted or needed. You guys remember, it's been maybe about a year or year and a half now that I've started like decluttering my makeup, doing low buys or no buys at all. Yeah, and so I've maintained that small-ish amount of makeup. And yeah, like I said, there's really not much in the market that I really wanted to try out until Emily Noel announced that she was going to have her Revolution makeup collaboration. So I've actually got that with me today, but this is not the palette that we're going to be talking about today. I'm just giving you a sneak peek because this will be the next video that's coming up, and I will be having a giveaway as well. I don't know when that video is going to come up because I will be quite busy this week, and in the weekend Duncan is actually coming over from Vietnam, coming to visit me here in Sydney, so you know, quality time with a husband is in order. So yeah, okay, enough of this blabbering. I just wanted to say hello to you guys again after being away for so long, and to start talking a little bit more about makeup again, but also like incorporating a few other things. Like I said, it's going to be more of a lifestyle channel than a beauty channel. Maybe I'll show you a little bit around Sydney area when I go cycling. But let's get on to the matter at hand, which is the Juvia's Place Zulu palette. That's what that beauty looks like. That's the outer packaging. I don't have the actual packaging anymore because like I don't keep that. So this are the colors in this palette. There's 9 huge ass eyeshadows in there. They're more the size of like blushes. I think these are the 36mm pans. Usually eyeshadows, like the MAC eyeshadows, are 26mm pans. So these are larger than that, as you can probably see if I put it against my face. It's huge. I love the pink inside. I'm not usually a person who gravitates towards pink, but if it's like bright pink like this that really shocks your eyes, then yeah, sure, why not? I have had this for a couple of months. I have honestly not been playing with it because I work in a school and this kind of bright makeup is not exactly appropriate. This isn't even like super bright, as you can probably tell, but like in real life this wouldn't fly. Okay, so these are the shades. Now I'm gonna cut into the videos of me swatching these so that you can see what it actually looks like swatched. I didn't do a brush or finger comparison, brush and finger comparison with the swatches. I just swatched them on my hand to show you what they actually look like. And they are true to color on the pan, and they do translate on your eyes like how it is. And now that I have shown you the swatches, I'm gonna cut into me applying this. So I did use that purple shade to put in the crease, the first thing that I did was to actually use my MAC Conceal and Correct, I think it would call it, the palette, to even out the skin tone on my lids, and then set that with a translucent powder. And then I went in with the purple shade that's right at the corner as my sort of my transition shade. Came in with that sort of rose gold shimmery shade all over the lids at first, and then went in with the brown that's like on the top to deepen the outer corners and inner corner of my eyes. And then at the bottom of my eyes, which I didn't show you on video, I've also added that same purple and that same rose gold, just to connect the colors off the top to the bottom. I have tried some of the other shades as well. I do like the mattes in here. The mattes are really good. They're really pigmented. They are like, even the yellow that normally doesn't really show up on my skin tone is pretty, pretty good, I would have to say. None of them actually stain my brushes, except maybe the purple one. If you use a white goat hair brush, it will stain, and also the reddish one. The bright pink at the bottom, that tends to stain white goat hair, but if you use like castor soap on it, it's just gonna go away and it'll work as perfect as it did before. Okay, so I do love the mattes. The there's like 3 shimmers in here and 6 mattes. 3 shimmers, I don't know why there are so many greens. Green is my favorite color, I'll tell you that. Green is my favorite color, but the greens, I don't know, they're nice. I do use them, but not as often as I thought I actually would. And they were actually the reasons why I bought this palette. I got it from their actual website, and it was on sale, I believe. At the time, it was like $17 that I paid for, $17 plus shipping for this. So it was pretty good deal. It's my first Juvia's Place product, and so far I'm impressed by the quality of the eyeshadows. I don't know if I'm ever gonna get through these eyeshadows. Now, I know they make is it the Sahara palette? I'm not sure which one it was, but it's like the smaller ones, but there's also more. Is it 12 or 16 shades in that particular palette? But this caught my attention because, as you guys know, I was getting sick of all the neutrals, especially the warm neutrals that was in the market, and Urban Decay is coming out with a Naked Cherry. Too late in the game, don't you think? Anyway, so I picked this up because I was really drawn to the colors in here, and on days that I'm not going to work, I do like to play with the colors in here. But yeah, I think it's really worth the money and worth the hype that Juvia's Place is getting. I also heard that they were coming out with their own line of, what do you call this? Foundation. So that would be interesting. And given that Juvia's Place has always been a brand that caters to women of color, I think that's going to be a really good shade range when it comes to their foundation. But let's see how it goes. I might be interested in picking that up. I haven't been buying foundations because, as you guys know, I have never really had a need for it. I've still got a few in my collection that I have to go through, but I'm slowly going through them. So anyway, yeah, what do I think about this palette? As I've been blabbering, I really like it. I think it's a good value. I think that if you are interested in shades like this that really pop in colors that are true to their color, to the pan, when you apply it on your lids, it looks exactly the same, then you are not going to be disappointed by this particular palette. I do really like it. And I recommend that you go and get it if you are looking for colorful eyeshadows. Juvia's Place also has got their own like mattes and neutrals and stuff like that. So if you're more into that, I'm sure they have something that will cater to your wants. Okay. And as I have mentioned earlier, I'm actually going to do my next video for the Emily Edit, the Wants palette. So stay tuned for that, because I'm also going to be announcing a giveaway. I bought an extra palette to give away, plus a few other things, so I'll show you in that video as well what's going to be given away. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comment section down below. Let's have a discussion. Do you own any of the Juvia's Place palettes or eyeshadows? Are you interested in the foundation that they are coming out with? What do you think about the brand in general? And have you tried it? Or if you haven't, are you looking into trying it? Yeah, let me know in the comment section down below. I appreciate always your comments, and I try to respond as much as I can. If you haven't already, please do subscribe and click that notification button so you know when I will be uploading, because to be honest, at this point, I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to do the regular upload, so I think it's just best that you get notified when I do put up a video, okay? It'll probably be like once a week, once every 2 weeks, or to be honest, whenever I feel like it, okay? I'll see you all again in the next video. Bye.